In this video, I explain you the difference between air cool and water cool engines. So in the last few videos, we already understand what is the air cool engines and what is the water cool engines and how it works. Now in this video, we go through the difference. So here on the left side, it is air cool engines and on the right side, it is the water cool engines. So from the name, we understand that the air cooling means air is used for the cooling of the engine. And water cooling means water is used for the cooling of the engine. Okay. So during water cooling, we understand one point is that when in the low temperature regions, means at an area have a low temperatures, at that time there is a freezing problems of the water. Okay. But in air cooling, there is a no danger of water freezing at the low temperatures because the air is not freeze. But in a water cooling, there is a danger of water freezing at the low temperatures. Second point. Maintenance is low and design is simple because there air cooling have a very few components. It have no pump is required, no another moving parts. So its maintenance is low and design is simple. But in a water cooling system, there is a lots of component like the pump, radiators. So maintenance is high due to radiators and design of the engine is complicated because why design is complicated? Because it's required engine jackets, okay, between the cylinder liners and the body of the engines, okay. So it is a very complicated work. That's why the design of the engine is complicated. In air cooling, design is simple because in outer body of the engines, we just need to provide the fins. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels if you're not subscribed, and also visit the playlist watching the more video related to mechanical engineering. And for more IC engine video, you go to the I symbol of top right screen of your laptop and mobile. Next point is regulation of cylinder temperature is not possible. Okay, because during air cooling, we studied that the cooling is uneven because of the flow of the air is different on a different sides of the cylinders. Because the air is flowing naturally, so we cannot control the flow of the air. Okay, at the some side it is higher, sometime it is the lower. That's why the temperature control is not possible in a air cooling. In a water cooling, regulation of cylinder temperature is possible because we are able to control the mass flow rate of the air. In thermostat system, we use the thermostat. That's why by using the water cooling, we are able to use regulation of the temperature. Next is specific fuel consumption is lower in a air cooling system, and in water cooling, specific fuel consumption is higher. Means fuel is higher used in water cooling system. Next point is weight to power ratio is low for air cooling. Means what is the weight of the engine divided by power is low. Means weight of the engine is low. Suppose for we are making the two engine for a same capacity. Okay, suppose the 10 kilowatt engine by using the air cooling and the 10 kilowatt engine by water cooling. Okay, so weight of the air cooling is lower because they not require radiators and pump. In a water cooling ratio, weight to power ratio is higher, means weight of the water cool engine is higher because it have more component like radiators and pump, and the water is also a part of the system. So it is increase the weight of the system. So weight to power ratio is higher. Next point is the suitable for low capacity engine, means air cooling is suitable only for low capacity engines and the water is suitable for a high capacity engine. How? Because the air have a low specific heat and the water have a high specific heat. What is the specific heat of the air? It is a 1.005. And what is the specific heat of a water? It is a 4.187. So what is the amount of heat transfer? Q is equal to mCp delta T. So Cp of the water is higher because the heat transfer is directly proportional to specific heat. So which substance have a higher specific heat? They are able to remove the more heat. So high capacity engine, we are required to remove the more heat, and in a low capacity engine, we are required to remove the low heat. That's why in a low capacity engine, we use the air. For a high capacity engines, we use the water. In air cooling, engine warm up is quickly. In a water cooling, engine warm up takes comparatively more time. Volumetric efficiency is low for air cool engines and volumetric efficiency is high for a water cool engines. In air cooling engine, cooling is non-uniform. As earlier discussed, that is a mass is different on a different side of the cylinder. So cooling is non-uniform. In a water cool engine, cooling is uniform. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned and liked the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends and comment on the video.